How are you?
Fine, sir.
Please tell me about your activities.
Reading, cooking, playing, gardening, and some other activities.
Okay, very good. It means every activity done by human being is known as human activity. Some activities give you some money. Here you see, human activities which generate income are known as economic activities. These activities may be classified in following: number 1, primary activity; number 2, secondary activity; number 3, tertiary; number 4, quaternary; and number 5, unary activities. Now, what is primary activity? Primary activities mean totally depend on environment, on nature. For example, you see here, agriculture, fishing, hunting and gathering, mining. These activities are depend on environment, on nature. So these are called primary activities. You see here, red collar. What is red collar? The people engaged in primary activities are called red collar. Okay? Why they are called red collar? Because of outdoor nature of their work. Now here, hunting and gathering, first example of primary activities. When man was not civilized at that time, and even today, in very tough climatic areas, here you see in North Asia, North America, South America, Africa, where climate is too tough. Here we found hunting and gathering activities. Okay? In these regions, people depend on their totally on cattle for their cloth, for their food, and other requirements. Now here, nomadic herding. Nomadic herdings, you can relate it with migration. Here you see in this area, here in this picture, with goat and sheep, people are moving from one place to another place. This is nomadic herding. Their place is not permanent. They move from one place to another place. Here is the area in Sahara Desert, in Central Asia, and now commercial livestock rearing. What is the difference between nomadic herding and commercial livestock rearing? It is more organized and capital intensive. Number 2, this is a specialized activity which only one type of animal is reared. Imported animals include sheep, goats, cattle, etc. Area or region: South America, North America, southern part of Africa continent, Australia continent, and here you see in this area of Asia continent. Next, you see primary subsistence agriculture. It is also known as shifting cultivation. It is also called slash and burn agriculture. Two terms: number 1, shifting; number 2, slash and burn. Shifting means people shift from one place to another place for agriculture. Slash and burn. Burn means, here you see this picture, burn, burning. They cut trees, burn, and get some fields for cultivation. After 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, or 5 years, when fertility decreases, they move from other area. There also they do same activity, slash and burn. This activity in different types of regions is known as different types of names. For example, in our country, in northeast states, it's known as Jhooming. Number in America and Mexico, Milpa. And in Indonesia, it is called Lada. Please note down. Slash and burn and Jhooming are important for your 12th class board examination and also important for competitive exams like IAS, PS and other examination. So, please write this on your notebook. Okay? Area, in north area of South America, in Central Africa, and here in monsoon type of region in Asia continent. Okay. Next, intensive subsistence agriculture. Intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by wet paddy and intensive subsistence agriculture dominated by crop other than paddy. Two types of subsistence agriculture. One, dominated by paddy, and second, others. Area especially this type of activity found in monsoon type of climate. Okay. Now plantation agriculture. Plantation agriculture was introduced by the Europeans in colonies situated in the tropics. Some of the important plantation crops are tea, coffee, cocoa, rubber, cotton, banana, sugar cane, etc. In this type of plantation, two or three things are important. Number one, it is done in very scientific way. In vast area, crop is dominated. Here you see banana and tea also. Here you see grapes. So there is grapes or coffee? What? Anybody can say? Coffee, not grapes. It is coffee. Coffee. In Brazil, coffee plantation is known as fazenda. It's important for board examination, fazenda, and also important for competition. Now, intensive commercial grain cultivation. See the word commercial. It means its main purpose is commercial. Commercial means to sell. Most of the product farmers sell, they get money. So it's called commercial cultivation. Commercial grain cultivation is practiced in the interior part of semi-arid lands of the mid latitudes. Wheat is the principal crop. Now distribution. World map, you see here in Asia continent, here in North America continent, in South America continent, and here in South Africa continent. Next, mixed farming. In mixed farming, equal emphasis is given on agriculture and animal husbandry. Both are same important. Yes, fodder crops are an important component of mixed farming. It means not only fodder is sown. Other types of crops are also sown. But in this picture, you see cattle are also seen. And in the same picture, you see here crops also. It means mixed farming means cultivation and animal husbandry. Okay. Distribution mostly you see in Europe continent and some part of Asia continent, and here in North America continent. Dairy farming. Dairy is the most advanced and efficient type of rearing of milk animals. Milk animals, it means animals who give us milk. In this type of agriculture, people depend on totally depend on animals for their food, for their cloth also. In dairy farming, mostly milk and milk produced like paneer etc. are produced. It is practiced mainly near urban and industrial centers. Question is, why near urban and industrial centers? Anybody can tell? Only answer is demand. Because of demand. In urban centers, in industrial areas, rich persons live. So, demand of dairy products is more in urban areas and industrial areas in comparison of rural areas. Now, distribution on world map. You see here, Europe continent, most maximum in Europe continent. In eastern part of Australia continent and northern region of North America continent. Viticulture. Now, earlier you have heard agriculture. Now the word is viticulture. Next word is sericulture, horticulture. These words are important for competition also, for your 12th class board exam, and the same way for competition also. You write down with number one, agriculture. Agriculture means crop production. Next, viticulture. Viticulture means grapes cultivation. Now, sericulture for silk production, or you can say for silkworm. And horticulture, agriculture of fruits and flowers. Again, agriculture, sericulture, viticulture and horticulture. You see, grapes cultivation is also known as viticulture. Viticulture is specialty of the Mediterranean region. Mediterranean is areas near Mediterranean Sea. There, grapes cultivation is mostly found. Market gardening and horticulture. I told you about horticulture. Here also horticulture. Market gardening and horticulture specialize in the cultivation of high value crops such as vegetables, fruits and flowers solely for the urban market. It means gardening and horticulture is especially for market. Why? Again, same thing. Because of demand. Here, truck farming. What is the meaning of truck farming? Truck farming, the regions where farmers specialize in vegetables, only the farming is known as truck farming. Gardening and marketing. Near urban areas, farmers produce vegetables, flowers. They go in market in urban areas by trucks. So This type is of agriculture is also known as truck farming. Now cooperative farming and collective farming. Cooperative means cooperation. Farmers make their cooperative societies. What is the role of cooperative societies? They help farmers for high yield variety seeds. Society tell them about technical things, about new techniques of agriculture. Society also provide some money for their help. Farmers can take loan from societies. It means they are not dependent on government. They are self-dependent by making cooperative societies. For example, in Maharashtra and Gujarat, somewhere sugar industries and somewhere dairy also, or Veka in Punjab, Parag dairy and other dairies. Now collective farming, the basic principle behind this type of farming is based on social ownership, the means of production and collective labor. In Soviet Union, kolkhoz was introduced. Collective farming is not private farming. It means owner is not a person, but here she collective ownership. And in Soviet Union, now Russia, collective farming was known as kolkhoz. Collective farming was introduced in Soviet Union. Mining is also a primary activity. There are two types of mines. Number one, surface mining or open. Number two, underground mining. Surface mining, here you see in the picture. But in underground mining, we get minerals from depths. Workers go inside mine, but there are so many problems also, like poisonous gases, flood, collapse of mines, so many problems. In this picture you see, workers are doing, they are doing mining work in underground mining. Now factors affecting mining. Number one, quantity. Number two, quality. Number three, technology. Mining works depends on minerals quantity, whether quantity of mineral is sufficient or not, whether quality of mineral is low quality or good quality. And next, technology. Suppose in your region, surveyor says that in this region gold may be found. Now three things we need to determine. Number one, whether gold is in big quantity or not, quality is good or not, and whether we have technology or not. If all three things are in proper way, then mining will develop. Now tertiary and quaternary activities. These activities are service sectors. Here you see spelling: healthcare, banking, restaurant, law, retail, transport and distribution. एज ए टीचर आई एम ऑल्सो इन टर्सरी ड्यूटी. डॉक्टर्स दे आर ऑल्सो इन टर्सरी ड्यूटीज. क्वार्टरली ड्यूटीज यू सी सम पिक्चर्स. सर्विस सेक्टर्स टर्सरी ड्यूटीज, क्वार्टरली ड्यूटीज एंड क्यूनरी ड्यूटीज. एग्जाम्पल्स ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स आफ्टर टर्सरी ड्यूटीज, ट्रांसपोर्ट, कम्युनिकेशन, फाइनेंशियल बैंकिंग, इंश्योरेंस, रियल इस्टेट, पर्सनल एंड प्रोफेशनल, ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर इन टर्सरी ड्यूटीज. क्वार्टरली ड्यूटीज इंफॉर्मेशन बेस्ड एंड आर एंड डी बेस्ड. क्यूनरी ड्यूटीज स्पेशलिस्ट, डिसीजन मेकर्स, कंसल्टेंट्स एंड पॉलिसी मेकर्स. टर्सरी ड्यूटीज, टर्सरी ड्यूटीज आर रिलेटेड टू सर्विस सेक्टर. टर्सरी ड्यूटीज इंक्लूड बोथ प्रोडक्शन एंड एक्सचेंज. कॉमन एग्जाम्पल्स आर टीचर, डॉक्टर, इलेक्ट्रिशियन एक्सेट्रा. टर्सरी ड्यूटीज स्पेशली हेल्प इन प्रोडक्शन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इस्टेब्लिश एन इंडस्ट्री यू विल नीड मनी. बैंक विल हेल्प यू. बैंकिंग इज टर्सरी एक्टिविटी. डॉक्टर्स, टीचर्स, बैंक सर्विसेज ऑल आर टर्सरी ड्यूटीज. ट्रेड एंड कॉमर्स टू थिंग्स आर इन ट्रेड. नंबर वन बाइंग, नंबर टू सेलिंग. द सेंटर्स वेयर बाइंग एंड सेलिंग बोथ एक्टिविटी टेक प्लेस आर कॉल्ड मार्केटिंग सेंटर्स. टू टाइप्स ऑफ मार्केटिंग सेंटर्स, रूरल मार्केटिंग एंड अर्बन मार्केटिंग. हियर सी इन पिक्चर रूरल मार्केट. इट इज नॉट वेल एस्टेब्लिश्ड. एंड इन अर्बन मार्केटिंग वेल एस्टेब्लिश्ड. एज यू नो, एज यू हर्ड अबाउट मॉल. रिटेल ट्रेडिंग एंड होलसेल ट्रेडिंग. फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग ट्रांसपोर्ट. रॉ मटेरियल, लोकेशन ऑफ सिटीज, टाउन्स, विलेज, इंडस्ट्रियल सेंटर्स, पैटर्न्स ऑफ ट्रेन बिटवीन देम, नेचर ऑफ लैंडस्केप, क्लाइमेट. दीज फैक्टर्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू सी पैटर्न ऑफ ट्रेड बिटवीन देम. इफ टू इंडस्ट्रियल सिटीज आर नियर आर ऑन डिस्टेंस ऑफ अबाउट 50 किलोमीटर्स, ट्रेड विल डेवलप, ट्रांसपोर्ट विल डेवलप बिकॉज ऑफ इंडस्ट्री. क्लाइमेट, नेचर ऑफ लैंडस्केप. इन प्लेन एरियाज ट्रांसपोर्ट विल इन बेटर वे, बट इन हिली एरियाज, इन डेजर्ट एरियाज वी कॉन्ट डेवलप ट्रांसपोर्ट इन गुड बेटर वे. कम्युनिकेशन सर्विसेज इन्वॉल्व द ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ वर्ड्स एंड मैसेज, फैक्ट्स एंड आइडियाज. नाउ डिफरेंस बिटवीन ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड कम्युनिकेशन. इन ट्रांसपोर्ट विजिबल थिंग्स मूव फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस, बट इन कम्युनिकेशन इनविजिबल थिंग्स. इट मीन्स सपोज गुड्स आर गोइंग फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस, इट इज ट्रांसपोर्ट. एंड इफ यू सेंड सम मैसेज एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टू समबडी, इट्स नॉट विजिबल, इट इज कम्युनिकेशन. टेलीकम्युनिकेशन, रेडियो, टेलीविजन, मास मीडिया, इंटरनेट. फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग टूरिज्म. टूरिज्म मीन्स गो फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन डिमांड, क्लाइमेट, लैंडस्केप, हिस्ट्री एंड आर्ट, कल्चर एंड इकोनॉमी. डिमांड, हाउ पीपल लाइक, व्हाट इज देयर इंटरेस्ट, वेदर दे वांट टूरिज्म आर नॉट, क्लाइमेट इज गुड आर नॉट, लैंडस्केप, पीपल ऑफ प्लेन एरिया दे लाइक टू गो इन हिली एरियाज और डेजर्ट एरियाज और कोस्टल एरियाज. इज देयर एनी हिस्टोरिकल प्लेस, हिस्टोरिकल थिंग. नेक्स्ट कल्चर एंड इकोनॉमी. होम स्टे, होम स्टे इज नोन बाई मेनी इन अदर इन मेनी एरियाज एज मेडिकेरे, कूर्ग एंड हेरिटेज होम्स. इन गोवा इट इज नोन एज हेरिटेज होम्स. इन कर्नाटका मेडिकेरे एंड कूर्ग. क्वार्टरली एक्टिविटीज, क्वार्टरली एक्टिविटीज सेंटर अराउंड रिसर्च डेवलपमेंट एंड मे बी सीन एज एन एडवांस्ड फॉर्म ऑफ सर्विसेज इन्वॉल्विंग स्पेशलाइज्ड नॉलेज एंड टेक्निकल स्किल्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैनेजर्स, ट्यूटर्स, कंसल्टेंट्स, सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपर्स एंड स्टैटिस्टिशियंस एक्सेट्रा. देयर इज लिटिल डिफरेंस बिटवीन टर्शियरी एक्टिविटीज एंड क्वार्टरली एक्टिविटीज. Here you see managers, consultants, software developments, they are more specialized. Means the people of quaternary activities are more specialized. Of culinary activities, the highest level of decision makers or policy makers perform culinary activities. Culinary activities are services that focus on the service, on the creation, interpretation of new and existing ideas and data interpretation, etc. These activities often referred to as gold color. Well, I told you about red color. Now you see the word gold color. Red color means persons engaged in primary activities, and gold color means persons engaged in culinary activities. Have you understood? Red color and gold color. Okay. The topmost policy makers in culinary activities, topmost policy makers, managers, others. Outsourcing. What is outsourcing? Outsourcing means to take help from outside. If you take any help in your business, it is BPO, business process outsourcing. And if you take help in study, it is KPO, knowledge process outsourcing. It may be two types. You may take help within country and from overseas. If you take help within country, it means outsourcing. But if you take help from another country or overseas, it will be called as offshoring. Again, outsourcing means to take help from outside, but offshoring to take help from another country or overseas. Now I conclude this topic. In important things, I told you about रेड कलर, गोल्ड कलर. रेड कलर मीन्स पर्सन एंगेज इन प्राइमरी एक्टिविटीज. गोल्ड कलर मीन्स पर्सन एंगेज इन क्यूनरी एक्टिविटीज. देन अगेन एग्रीकल्चर मीन्स प्रोडक्शन ऑफ क्रॉप्स. विटीकल्चर मीन्स एग्रीकल्चर ऑफ ग्रेप्स. सेरीकल्चर मीन्स प्रोडक्शन ऑफ सिल्क और सिल्क वर्म. एंड लास्ट हॉर्टिकल्चर मीन्स एग्रीकल्चर ऑफ फ्रूट्स एंड फ्लावर्स. हैजार्ड्स इन माइनिंग आई गिव ए एक्टिविटी. सपोज यू हैव टू गो जापान. What type of formalities, what type of papers you need to go Japan? Make a list. This is activity. Make a list of those papers which you need to go Japan. And what type of climate is found in Japan? Okay. Thanks.